going on? Here we are. Oh, that was some loud aircraft. So we're busy today, but we're still gonna fly anyways. Here we are in Japan. Here we are in Japan, in Tokyo. We're boarding a Boeing 737-800 from ANA Airlines, and we are going all the way down to Nagasaki to drop the bomb. And finally, it's quiet. And boom, we have entered the cabin for a reason like this. So, okay. It's a beautiful cabin. Nothing's wrong with it. And let's check the landing gears. Gears are down. Thrusts are idle. TCAS must be off. Not sure what else to check. Oh yeah, the hydraulic pumps must be off. Except for the engine pumps. We don't have the engines on. So yeah, let's now kick in the battery, and I think, yeah, we can go to the external power. Nice. So everything checks out. Oh yeah, the emergency lights is definitely turned those on. Position lights are on. And is there anything else? And we're obviously gonna do lots of stuff a little later. Let's turn on the IRS list. Let's check on how long they'll take. Uh-oh, I think I forgot something. The default is set to fast. No, yeah, it's instant. Okay, so let's disregard that. This is totally unrealistic. Let's go to professionalism by going to the MFC. Let's go to setup and just to see the IRSS options. Simulation, IRS options, so it must be not instant, realistic. That's an IRS position. Yeah, shut up. To configure everything. I mean, not really. But anyways, we have a job to do. Let's check some stuff. Let's check the latest indication that we are online, but let's just regard that. Let's fly recorder. Yep, turns off and then turns on the light. Emergency escape ropes are closed. Circuit breakers, yeah, they are all not hot. I apologize for the FPS. Everything checks out. So yeah. Now the lights are, oh, I forgot the this chime. There's no smoking signs. We don't want any sort of accidents that are happening in the cabin when the passengers board. And yeah, okay. So let's check some other stuff. The payload. Oh no, we're gonna board a little bit. Is that up to you? And then fuel. This is totally unrealistic. Let's put this number. Yeah. Doesn't shake. I always thought it shaked. Anyways, and speaking of which, let's now go to. Let's turn on jetway. Where's the jetway? Oh, yeah, there it is. Boom. And automatically. This thing goes so goes gently. And we should see it over here. Oh, it's too far away. And, oh no, what are you doing? And flight is canceled. No, never mind. I'll do this flight as fast as possible. You're on the Boeing 737. What's the worst thing that can happen? But this is taking so long, so never mind. Let's open the doors. The door, anyways. For whatever reason, you have to do it. You open it manually. It doesn't open automatically like in the stairs. And let's request fuel charge. That was exactly what they're gonna do. Expected, so we're gonna do this fast. We have no other choice. Also, it's 5 degrees outside. This already isn't live weather, live time, so I don't know if this is realistic or it's just weird weather from Japan. It's attaching. We're gonna have to wait until 2040 until it attaches. Taking so long. I hate it. I hate it, please. Come on. Oh, there it is. Start feeling. Why do you have to do it from here? They can just do it on their own. It's too unrealistic. We need GSX, definitely. Whoops. There we go. So, yep, let's sit that in. Using our foot and our feet. Bingo. And let's now go to the FMC. And here we are, Airbnb Eric 2313, December 28th to January 25th. 2024, so yeah. Yeah, we have the correct aircraft. And also, I didn't check the where it said. Oh yeah, there it is. The tail number is correct. Imagine if it wasn't. Anyways, let's enter a reference airport here. RJTT. GPS position just to be a little more precise. You can just grab these, grab the coordinates from here. And we are now aligned. That's so unrealistic. Route. Yes. And let's request flight plan. Oh no, wait, never mind. I forgot to load the sim brief. The sim brief thing, here we go. Alright, now we're trying to flight back. Data from Simbrief. There we go. Oh, that was so fast. And okay. I forgot which camera position. Oh my god. Okay. Yeah, Simbrief. So fuel. Not this, it's just the route request. Please. I would really appreciate request. Route uplink ready.
Floating.
This is so awesome. I love Sunbrief. There we go. We now have the route. But let's go to the departure, which actually is inside.
Departure is...
here. Where is it? Is it this one? Oh, yeah. Taking off from 0304. The route
activated?
No, let's say the arrival. Stars, we're not going to use any stars, so okay, no more. So, activate, execute, boom. I think we are set, right? It's a fueling process. We're still being fueled. And let's test some other stuff, such as fires. Yeah. Actually, this camera. Let's check this guy. It turns on. Warnings. Nice. And then the cargo warnings. Nice. Oh yeah, and the manual gear. It's down. Okay. So, okay, we are now set. Now let's also, for now, we need passengers. So let's bring them in. Just for time. Bring them in. Let's also release the galleys. We already have enough food.
And how many passengers? According to somebody,
128 passengers. Start. Nice. We are now boarding passengers. And we're gonna have to board also the bag of the baggage. It's pretty straightforward. Not really the biggest deal. Let's release the fuel truck. And by the way, turn them on. Yeah. Let's turn them on. Is there anything else? The APU? I mean, APU is supposed to be on 15 minutes before pushback and engine start. I'm not sure if this is going to take 15 minutes to board it. I don't know. I think it's going to take like 10. It's also said the Be 30,000 feet. Oh, whoops. We're not going that high. It's going to be on a fairly low altitude compared to other ones. And the airport elevation in Nagasaki. Eight feet, which is practically sea level, so it's fine.
It's gonna be a cool airport, actually.
It's in an island, from Nagasaki, so yeah, it's gonna be worth it. So where were we? No, there we go. Let's now request the loaders. Traffic seems loud.
And we are carrying.
Oh, come on. We are carrying. How much? Payload. Alright, cargo 6,400 kilos. I mean, pounds.
6,400.
My own calculator, 6,400 divided by 2 is 3,200. That was so obvious. Why I didn't have to use a calculator? 3,200. Yeah, it happens all the time. You try to do something in a calculator that you could have easily done in your mind, which is embarrassing. And okay, so let's now turn on the P. Once and for all. We're already done with fuel. Is there anything else? Not really. Everything else seems straightforward. All the packs are content to auto for now. Yeah. Anything else over here? Not really. Something done. Oh yeah, I forgot to test this. Yeah. Actually, oh come on. This is so buggy. Where was I? Oh yeah, the lights. Yeah, the lights are beautiful. Oh, I really like testing them. Not in this time, but. But yeah, everything checks out. Just now check. And let's start loading. The passengers, the loaders. Loading the loaders, which didn't make any sense. So they're loading the cargo bays. And according to this, our AP is now available. Let's check this. We now have AC current, and we have fairly enough current over here. So yeah, let's now disconnect the ground power unit. And in a few moments we're gonna disconnect. I mean, we're gonna turn on the air conditioner for our passengers. Which, by the way, how many do we have? We have 80 passengers on board. And we can still wait. Like 2 minutes, maybe. I don't know. Yeah. This is so buggy. And okay. So let's go to departure and find our SID, which is what was it? It began with an M. Minox, yeah. To pin that on the airport, I forgot. Airport briefing, airport info. Yeah, we are here. So, yeah. This is straightforward, and let's go to arrival. No, arrival's not necessary for now. So yeah, pin charts we have here, this guy. And so what we're gonna plan is that we're gonna push back the tail to our left and nose to our right. We taxi on Echo and on Julia. And then we cross what 16 right. This is a little too complicated. Let's see. Julia, oh, we go to Alpha 15 and then Lima 15.
No, not Lima 15. It's Bravo. After Kilo. No, after Julia, we're gonna have to go Alpha 15 and then Tequila and then cross 163 and then Bravo. We go to Bravo until Bravo 1. I got runway 04. It's a not a really short runway. It's like 8,000. We're gonna have to use full tow then maybe. But yeah, we just take off towards the northeast. And let's check the star. It's just straightforward. Yeah, straightforward. We go to a runway heading and then we do eventually turn above this area. We turn right to TT502. And then we just follow through at or above 5,000, at or above 9,000 Benji, Psycho, at or above 13,000, and at or above flight 170. So yeah, it's gonna be a fair climb. And by the way, let's check if that actually checks out here. Yeah, turn on the air conditioning. I have to set a custom camera. So yeah, set this to plan. Well, let's go to FMC and then to legs. Plan room and magic happens. The cold signs. Yeah, coincides. And it also has to coincide with the route, which is actually quite detailed, so that is why some routes save me a lot of time. All the way south, southwest. Oh no, not too much. That's way too detailed. Yeah, there we go. There's Nagasaki. And the arrival, that should be up to us. Approach. So yeah, I think this is it for the departure. There's not really any difficulty other than the traffic. There's the weather. Departure. The weather is... oh yeah, Firm 04 seems good. And also the wind is 0504, so it's nothing, literally. And altimeter 30.17, so let's put that in. 30.17. There we go. We're literally at sea level. And so, yeah. Yeah, the weather's not really an issue, fortunately. And let's check the FMCs to see if what's going on with the passengers. So now we'll lose these guys. For passengers, so we should hurry up. Let's go root. Perfinet. Plus perfinet. Let's load our zero fuel weight first. And then let's plus perfinet. To do that all that for us easily. Okay, let's load that in. Execute. And no, we are not going to fight all 3-2, so this is really not too accurate, unfortunately. So, execute. Transition altitude 14,000. Is it 14,000?
14,000, yeah.
Okay. I don't know what my man. That is the EFB. That is the beauty of this guy. So yeah, performance tool. I love this. So it's import from OFP. Select 2004 as our departure. This is correct. Input on aircraft just to be realistic. Takeoff lights optimal, rating optimal. NTIS off, not necessary. Weight CG, it's packs on. Packs on. We can turn them off. It's better. It's not the longest runway. If you want it, now it's currently. Okay, so the. The RTG's takeoff form. So, yeah, takeoff form. Is there a soft temperature? Yeah, 42 degrees. 42 degrees Celsius. Nice. 42 degrees Celsius, and I think that's it for this page. Yep, let's go to takeoff, go to the next page. Okay, yeah, 0805. Slow climb, not necessarily that one, too. Oh yeah, what about this guy? Where is it? Acceleration height, 1,500, yeah, okay. Confused buttons. So then what are the flaps? I'm gonna check. Flaps are 5. Flaps 5. Center of gravity is automatic. Trim, let's see if that checks out. Trim, 5.05. Yeah. It's not necessary to check. It's there. So yeah. We have the info. It's now some 145. And then plus 15. Plus 15, which is 145, 160. And let's start over here. 043. Oh, sorry about that. 043. Oh, whoops, it's over there. No, it's actually over there. 043. Bingo. And the initial altitude can be 9,000. Also set here the departure heading. Departure heading. Flight direction is coming from. I don't think this is necessary. Is there any info about so yeah, this is it. No frequency needle, not any needle. Okay. let's just get rid of everything related to the ground. Okay, it's removed. So yeah, let's remove the chocks. I'm also. Oh, and also, now that we can load the doors, let's close this guy. And then the pillar, now that we can load the doors, down the doors, the ground services. Yeah. So you can put them in a later moment. And over here, let's set the lights. And over here, let's turn on the yaw denter. Fuel pumps. I think I saw some fuel in the center pump, and in the center tank. So it's also put there as well. Yeah, there it is. Over here, not much over here. Let's have time. Yeah, so they can already. Doors are closed, important. And so now turn on the hydraulic, electric. And turn on the window heats. And these could be on until after engine start. Let's turn on anti-collision light. And I don't know. Let's see over here. Oh no, no, over here. Something. Oh yeah, we need. It's okay. Everything else, it's fine. So. Pushback, pre-planned pushback. We agreed on going tail to the left, nose to the right. Yep. Over here. So go over here. Not much. We can just go for like this. Let's wait a little bit. And so, yeah, this has been a little complicated. And also, we don't need this. We can just go right over here. Yep. So it's tucked in. And the shape pushed back. Oh, what happened? Start engine number two. Thank you.
immediately after this guy stops, it's to park and break his son. Oh, it automatically removed the chocks. I think I forgot to remove them. And so, yeah. Let's disregard that. Let's go over here. Everyone seen? Where was I? I don't know. Everyone remember. Yeah, over here. Something else, later lights, etc. A bit too much noise for the passengers. I forgot to mention that Nagasaki is one of the names of the airports from the first world update of the simulator, which is Japan. And oh, it is like so beautiful. Downtown Japan. That's beautiful. FSLTO actually complements it with live traffic liveries. I highly recommend it. It's a free add-on. It just places all these live traffic aircraft with an accurate livery, and you get this high-quality flight. It's completely free, but the amount of money it gives you is so much. especially if you're on high settings. I'm on medium. My specs aren't really that high, but it's something. I can see downtown. It looks very beautiful. FPS, not the best, but I want to lower it down to low end. Because it would look very ugly. I don't want that. High, I'm a medium, I'm happy with it. With my PC. Text a little bit faster because we're still quite far away. It's also funny as ever, this approach, the approach towards this runway is taking one for the left. You actually pass over downtown, do you? Or do you just go around like this high tech approach? I'm thinking. Oh no, yes, we do. It's funny. Yeah, because in New York there's in JFK there's an airport. I think this is Texas, right? But there's a runway that you, if you pass straight over, you're gonna pass over downtown Manhattan. And after 9/11 or I don't know, after safety, they restricted that. So for that runway, you're gonna have to make a sort of high-tech approach to this thing. Which is fine, safer, ironically, but it doesn't matter. Fuji. Take off, I don't know if we're gonna see it. If we do, it's nice. If not, it's fine. But yeah, should consider parking in a closer spot for obvious reasons. Okay, that's beautiful. So what I just realized that this airport actually uses the imperial sort of measurement. It uses inches of mercury instead of hectopascals. So what I realized, it's funny. It's not the only non-American non-US country. Mexico also uses the inches of mercury. Slow down. I think the rest of Latin America, I don't know. It's purely American, and then in Europe you only have hectopascals for obvious reasons. Stop a little bit just to, you know, slow down just a little bit too much. I really do wish I'm not forgetting something. forgot to say. There's even a runway that's an island, literally. You have to cross on a bridge, a taxiway bridge, which it's actually quite fun. I've done that a long time ago. And, oh my god, do you have to do this? Yeah, sort of. Just to make you slow down or something. Slow you down or something. Finally on the runway after like an hour. The rudder is just a little bit off on the PMDG. It just doesn't realize it until that you're moving it until like when you're on the grass. Or you just here. Oh, I forgot the trim, which is fine. Oh my god, what is going on? It's speed up or something? Oh yeah, the rubber this time kind of works. Anyways. So, yeah. 40% on one. Yoke. Down on yoke. Toga. It's alive.
Not.
Chuck. 100. Rotate. D-rate. Yeah.
finish doesn't mean I have to turn on PAX fairly quick. Almost did an MCAT maneuver. I feel, oh yeah, it's, deal with it. Continue to climb 20,000 feet. Feel. Directly over Mount Fuji. So that is going to be fun. Is there any turbulence? No, not really. So for now, let's turn off the seatbelt. sustain under much pressure. And we can now clear ourselves to foil.